Hello, ladies of the Garden Club. I'm Felicity Garrard, and I'd like to share with you my great appreciation of this marvellous green oasis right in the middle of our busy, sprawling city. I've loved the farm ever since I arrived in Ottawa as a new bride in the 70s with my Canadian husband. Having grown up in the English countryside and with farmers and agricultural engineers featuring prominently in my family tree, I never minded the gentle waft of cow and pig that occasionally drifted across our home not far from Dow's Lake. The farm soon became a regular haunt as my family and I discovered the myriad things it has to offer. But during this pandemic year, it has become even more important to me, and I'm sure to many other people, as a vital escape from the strictures and anxieties of the lockdown. The Central Experimental Farm covers 426 hectares between Carling Avenue and Baseline Road in Ottawa's West End, and was established by the federal government in 1886 to support Canadian agriculture by undertaking critical scientific research and by developing and demonstrating good farming methods. These maps will give you some idea of its size and location, and as I'll be showing you, there are many different areas to explore, depending on your mood. I won't go into a detailed history of the farm. This beautiful book by Helen Smith, with photos by Mary Bramley, will tell you all you need to know about the farm's founders and its pioneering scientists and horticulturalists. But I will take you on a photographic stroll through some of the many different areas of this wonderful Ottawa resource. There's a fascinating farm museum, barns full of animals, great for the grandchildren, huge wide open fields, and roads for a brisk walk or cycle, the magnificent trees of the Arboretum to wander through, the tangled natural fields of the Fletcher Wildlife Garden, or the backyard garden with its bird feeders and native plants. Fun to experience too are the quirky sculptures on the site of Ottawa's future botanical garden. And last but not least, the seasonal glories of the ornamental gardens, which will be the main focus of my slide presentation. I hope you enjoy the photographs and the music too. Thank you.